Hey everyone, Dr. Jeff Peng here. We've known for a while now that an ACL injury to the knee increases your risk of developing knee osteoarthritis in the future. Now we have better data to tell us just how much increased risk there is. I want to dive into two new articles recently published in the American Journal of Sports Medicine. And if you've had an ACL tear in the past, you'll definitely want to watch to the end because after hearing the data, you're going to want to be more proactive in treating your knees to prevent the development of knee arthritis. Let's dive right in. Now, if this is the first time you're watching one of my videos, my goal is to help each and every one of you live an active and healthy lifestyle. So if that's something you're interested in, please consider subscribing to my channel. ACL tears are common sporting injuries, and surgical treatment with ACL reconstructions have high success rates in getting people back to being physically active. But even with reconstructive surgery, people who have had an ACL injury have 7 times the risk of developing arthritis in the knee or requiring a knee replacement surgery. This study followed 235 patients for 25 years after ACL reconstructive surgery, and they found that 60% of these people had osteoarthritis in the knee that had the ACL tear, compared to only 18% in the other knee. And there are many possible explanations for this. While surgeons try their best to restore the full function of the ACL, there could still be persistent laxity in the knee. Continued instability of the knee contributes to cartilage damage, which leads to arthritis. Meniscus injuries at the time of the ACL tear also increases the risk of developing a degenerative knee. Now, unfortunately, you can't change these outcomes, but what you can change is what you do after an ACL injury. There's a lot of data to suggest that many athletes and weekend warriors never return to full strength in their injured knee. And in my previous video, I discussed how muscle weakness, especially involving the knee extensor mechanism, increases the risk of developing arthritis by 30% by keeping the affected leg nice and strong through a maintenance exercise program. You can potentially decrease your risk of developing arthritis. Now, historically, exercise therapy was the only risk factor that you could change. But now, there may be something else. Researchers are actively looking at how we can treat the microenvironment of the knee after an ACL injury. Can we alter the biochemistry of the joint after an injury to decrease the future risk of developing arthritis? Here's what we know so far. We know there is a significant increase in inflammatory signaling cells in the knee after an ACL injury. Many of these inflammatory mediators and proteins can cause damage to the cartilage and weaken the structures in the knee. Over the course of a month following an ACL injury, these inflammatory markers slowly decrease while other important growth factors slowly increase. The release of all of these growth factors create an environment more conducive to healing. This may explain why many surgeons have noticed better surgical outcomes waiting about 1 month after an ACL injury to perform surgery. And similar to how surgeons are analyzing the inflammatory markers in the knee before and after injury, sports medicine physicians are constantly thinking about inflammatory markers well after surgery. Degenerative knees have significant increases in inflammatory markers, similar to right after an ACL tear, but unlike after an injury where growth factors start to increase, inflammatory markers stay persistently elevated in arthritis. So how can we address this? How can we reset the biochemistry in a degenerative knee or a knee at risk for degeneration? Well, one potential way of doing this is by using PRP injections. PRP stands for platelet-rich plasma. They contain an incredible amount of growth factors that can change the microenvironment of an injured knee to keep it neutral and hopefully prevent the development of arthritis. Many sports medicine physicians are recommending a PRP injection after an ACL surgery to keep the microenvironment of the knee as healthy as possible. Others are also recommending PRP injections well after surgery for maintenance therapy. This is an exciting area of research, and hopefully we can use PRP to help prevent post-traumatic knee arthritis. Now, if you already have signs of knee osteoarthritis, then you'll definitely want to check out this video where I discuss all forms of non-surgical treatment options. Thanks for watching.